They are flying away. One key landing. It's flying off. Luckily not towards the ocean, but it's flying off.
Good morning, you guys. Welcome to New to DYC to the E-Scene E58 second-hand buy that I refurbished. Yesterday evening I did a little test flight to see if it worked perfectly and test out the video camera. But it was getting, the sun was just setting behind the dike, so there was very low light conditions. And I saw some graining on the video quality, so I want to do the same test flight that I did yesterday. Test out the video quality during the sun that is up and shining bright, plus minus, because it's still a little bit cloudy, but there's a lot more sunlight. Plus I did the dipole antenna upgrade, modification, to boost the range, so I feel more safe to fly the E-Scene E58 at a longer distance, so we can get some nicer shots from a lot higher without losing the drone and flying away. So let's do this test flight and see how much range we have. I hope we can get to the end of the field around those bushes, trees, and then come back again. Connected. Start recording. Monkey takeoff. And it takes off. High rate so we can fight the wind, because there's more wind today than yesterday. And yes, we are really fighting the wind. But I'm still in control. But it's doing weird stuff. The control is getting... yeah. So I've made it to the end of the grass, but did start doing weird stuff and losing signal. I do need to improve the antenna on the drone to let it poke out the canopy much further. That improves a lot with the signal connection with the transmitter. But it is a nice distance that we can fly. You can hear the wind. I love the flight of yesterday evening, because there was no wind at all. Wind quiet. It made this little light drone much easier to fly, of course. But the props didn't break. The arm just bent. They pick up the force. But so. Land. So I know about the distance that we can fly. I have some video quality with the sun shining into the sun and looking with the sun in the back. That always creates better video quality, because there's more light shining into the camera. And because I still have battery from the old drone that I lost, from the old E58, I got 4 batteries now. So I got plenty of time to do some really proper test flights. I like this playground. Get it. Sit there. Lost connection. Okay. Still got connection, so we started recording again. One key takeoff. Level 2. So we can fight the wind better. And altitude hold works really good in the wind at level 2. Keeps the range pretty nice. The altitude pretty high. Let's fly back. Still fly really good. Go low below. Nice. It survived, it survived. Oh, wind is picking up.
It's because it's windy, it's wobbling around a lot, but... Oh, and I see one of the legs is moved around, so... Take a... where it's dry. And land it. Now it's flying good again. Oh. It really looks like a DJI Mini Mavic, but that's a lot cheaper and a lot more affordable. So if you crash this little drone, you're not gonna cry. That's one thing, that's for sure. Plus, there are plenty of spare parts. You can buy every part separate, so you can keep on fixing this little drone. Like I repurposed this little drone that I bought secondhand, because I knew how good it flies. I loved the first E58 that I had. I made plenty of videos of it. And if you're interested in doing this range boost antenna, dipole antenna modification, then check out the links. It will be linked up over on your screen. I love this one. I got some really good control. I really love this joystick. It's nice and wide. Got some really good gimbals. Wow. It's still the cheap toy gimbals, but they have a really nice button on it. So I got some really good control with my thumbs. And it flies like it's on rails. Downside is, it just don't have GPS, and every time you start up the drone, you need to retrim it. Every time you pull out a new battery in it, you have to retrim it. That's the only downside. But for all the other effects, it flies super fast. It can take... It feels like it's flying on rails. I got some really good control. I love EE scenes. They always doing a good job in doing the pitch tuning from the factory. They really fly this drone and fine tune it perfectly. Look how smooth it is, even with wind. The battery is getting empty, so it's time to find a dry spot and land. Only 30 euros, this is not a bad drone. And that was just a pilot error, it was my mistake. But it's a good durability test, because the prop didn't break. The arm just bent a little bit, bent it back in place, it clicks, and it's nice. I just have to clean off and dry it off again, because you're super close to the water, and that's no good, of course. Electronics and water don't mix. But it's flying really good. I refurbished it really nice. I got some extra range with the dipole antenna. I got it up to 300 meters the last time I did this upgrade with my first E58. And I don't have 3 meters at this moment, so I still need to improve this little antenna in the back to get more range. But for now, it's good enough. Let's go to the beach and do some more test flying and get some cinematic footage with this little drone. Well, the sun is up. Let's go. Here at the coast now, but there's a lot more wind here because we are right at the sea. There's nothing that is blocking the wind because it's just got open water. You can do all at once. The drone is ready, the phone is ready, it's recording. One key to take off. And it's off. Now let's try the similar footage that we did yesterday. Just drift the drone, not towards the sea, of course. little bit more weight so we can fight. Let's see. Now that we got also more weight with the antenna, let's go up a lot higher. Still reacting to my input. But because of the wind, I need to control it and keep it steady, and that's difficult in the wind. There's no GPS. That's a shame. That's the one thing that is a shame of the E58 Mini Mavic, the little clone. Land. Monkey landing. Oopa. There it goes. But luckily, the arms can move. I got foldable arms, and they will take much of the hit, so the props don't break. Let's see if I'm correct. Yes, the arms did fold, and the props didn't break. Super nice. Just fold them back. And those birds. Check out my birds. Flying away. They are flying away. Monkey landing. It's flying off. Luckily not towards the ocean, but it's flying off. Where did it land? Up there. Not in the little river. I'm lucky. Again, this is the Netherlands. We have a lot of water close by. Everywhere you go, there's water. Oh, I'm so lucky. And right away to the little lake where we got some extra footage to make. Luckily it lands right there in the grass. So I will just keep it at 60 meters. Anything beyond that is not safe. Let's fly the drone. And still working. Still working very nice. Oh.